When tackling most counting questions, we should begin by asking the question, does order matter here? So, for example, if we let the following letters represent Joan's 10 friends, is inviting friends A, D, and H different from inviting friends D, A, and H? The answer here is no, since order does not matter, and we are still inviting the same three friends. So, if order does not matter, we are dealing with a combination question, and we have a nice formula for combination questions. Please note that there are two types of notation that we can use for combinations. I'm going to be using the first one. So we are told that Joan has 10 friends and she must choose three of them. This is equal to the following. Now, if we simplify the information in our brackets, we get this. And now we can expand both of our factorials. Notice that we can eliminate several numbers in the numerator and the denominator to give us the following. And this evaluates to be 120. So our answer is B. All right, in this question, we are selecting K people from a group of 8 people. Now, since the order of the selected people does not matter here, this is a combination question. So the total number of ways to select K people from 8 people is equal to 8 choose K. Our goal is to find values of K such that 8 choose K is equal to 56. At this point, we'll check each of our answer choices. Now, as we do so, we're going to use this nice shortcut for evaluating combinations. It says n choose r is equal to the first r values of n factorial, all divided by r factorial. So, for example, 8 choose 1 will be equal to the first 1 value of 8 factorial divided by 1 factorial. Similarly, 8 choose 2 is equal to the first 2 values of 8 factorial divided by 2 factorial. 8 choose 3 is equal to the first 3 values of 8 factorial divided by 3 factorial, and 8 choose 4 is equal to the following. At this point, when we evaluate each of these, we get the following numbers. So we can see here that 8 choose 3 is equal to 56. Now, to evaluate our remaining options, we can apply this nice rule. It says that n choose r is equal to n choose n minus r. For example, 10 choose 3 is equal to 10 choose 7. So let's apply this. Since 8 choose 1 is equal to 8, we know that 8 choose 7 is also equal to 8. Similarly, since 8 choose 2 equals 28, we also know that 8 choose 6 is equal to 28. Since 8 choose 3 equals 56, we know that 8 choose 5 equals 56. So here we find another instance where 8 choose k is equal to 56. So it appears that when k equals 3 or 5, 8 choose k equals 56. So our answers are 3 and 5.
Okay, here's how we'll go about this. For any diagonal, we have a starting vertex and an ending vertex. So first of all, we have 10 choices for our starting vertex. Suppose we pick this as our starting vertex. Notice that how many choices could be the ending vertex? Well, it can't be itself, and it can't be either the adjacent ones. It has to go to a non-adjacent vertex. So if we get rid of those three, there are 7 possible destinations. So 10 times 7, which is 70. But notice that we've overcounted because, for example, this diagonal right here would get counted twice, once as this, with this as the start, and once with this as the start. So it would get counted exactly twice. And therefore, we have to divide this by 2, which is 35. And that is the number of possible diagonals in a regular decagon.
Okay, let's take the task of building a vehicle here and break it into 5 stages. Stage 1 will be to select whether or not we want a sunroof, stage 2 whether or not we want a stereo, and so on. So beginning with stage 1, in how many ways can we decide whether or not we want a sunroof? Well, 2 ways. Either we have a sunroof or we don't have a sunroof. The same goes for a stereo. 2 ways. Either have a stereo or don't have a stereo. And so on. So the number of ways to build our car will be the product of these stages, which is equal to 32. So column A is equal to 32, which is greater than column B. So our answer is A. All right, we have 5 female employees and 1 male employee. Our goal here is to create a three-person committee such that the male employee must be in the committee. So let's take care of this condition right away. We'll take our male employee and place him on the committee. So the question now becomes, in how many ways can we pick two more people to be on this committee? Well, since the order in which we select these two people doesn't matter, this is a combinations question. Now we have five people to choose from, and we must choose two of them. So we can accomplish this in five choose two ways. Now using the following formula, we can evaluate five choose two to be equal to 10. So our answer here then is A. Okay, we have six employees, and the manager must choose three of them to be on a committee. Now, the important point to recognize here is that the order in which the employees are selected for the committee does not matter. For example, selecting person A, then person B, then person C for the committee is the same as selecting person B, then A, then C. We end up with the same committee either way. So since the order in which we select our employees does not matter, we're looking at a combinations question. So we have six employees, and we must choose three of them. This can be accomplished in 6C3 ways. Now, when we apply the following formula, we see that 6C3 is equal to 20. From here, we can see that column B is greater than column A, which means our answer is B. In order to maximize the number of candies we can give to one child, we must minimize the number of candies we give to the other 9 children. Now let's let these 10 bags represent our 10 children. The fewest candies we can give to any one child is 1. So let's give 1 candy to our first child. Since no two children can receive the same number of candies, the fewest candies we can give to the second child is 2. The fewest candies we can give to the third child is 3, and so on. We've now minimized the number of candies we give to the first 9 children, and the 10th child will receive the remaining candies. So how many candies have we given so far? Well, we need to find the sum of these numbers. There's a nice formula for finding the sum of integers from 1 to n. This is equal to n times n plus 1 divided by 2. So the sum of our numbers will be 9 times 10 divided by 2, and this is equal to 45. So far we've given out 45 candies. So the number of candies we can give to the last child will be 100 minus 45, which equals 55. So our answer is E. All right, our task here is to count the total number of triangles that can be created by using the given points as vertices. So here's one possible triangle, here's another, and here's another. The important point to recognize here is that each triangle is uniquely defined by 3 points. So for example, this triangle is defined by the points B, D, and G. So the question really becomes, in how many ways can we select 3 points from the points we've been given? Well, to answer this question, we must first recognize that the order in which we select our points does not matter. For example, selecting the points B, D, and G creates the same triangle as selecting the points D, B, and G. So since order does not matter here, we can solve this question using combinations. So we have 7 points to choose from, and we must choose 3 of them. This can be accomplished in 7 choose 3 ways. Now to evaluate this, we'll apply the following formula. And when we plug our numbers in, we get a total of 35 different triangles. So column B is greater than column A, which means our answer is B. Okay, let's begin by moving our question here. Now using the following rule, we can take our fraction and break it into 2 fractions. Now let's evaluate each fraction individually. Now for the red fraction, we know that 10 factorial looks like this, and 7 factorial looks like this. Notice that numerator and denominator share several terms. So we can eliminate these terms, leaving us with 10 times 9 times 8. This equals 720. Now onto the blue fraction. 8 factorial and 7 factorial look like this. And once again, we have several terms in common with the numerator and denominator. We can cancel these out, leaving us with 8. So now to evaluate our fraction, this will be equal to 720 minus 8, which is equal to 712. So our answer is E.